This is the first major exhibition to explore the life and legacy of Thomas Becket, and it brings together some of the most important objects related to his cult. Beautiful golden reliquaries to books that he might have owned, an object that will be in the very centrepiece of the exhibition, which is an entire stained glass window from Canterbury Cathedral, known as one of the miracle windows. Almost immediately after his death, people began to report that Becket was performing miracles. Canterbury Cathedral became one of the most important pilgrimage destinations in Europe until Becket's cult was destroyed on the orders of Henry VIII during the Reformation. The glass is actually a remarkable survival. It has suffered some damage over the years, particularly in the 1640s due to Puritan iconoclasm. And in the 1660s, there was some effort at restoration, but a lot of the panels were put back into the window in the wrong order. In the late 19th century, there was another opportunity to try and restore some of the glass, but a lot of these stories are still relatively mixed up and there's still some confusion around which miracles in particular they depict. So in preparation for this exhibition, when the window was taken down from Canterbury Cathedral and was in the stained glass studio, it gave experts a chance to take another look at the glass and think about the narrative order of these stories. One of the kind of most momentous discoveries was when Leonie was looking at a panel that had previously been unidentified. It shows a man sitting beside Becket's tomb having his legs washed. And when Leonie was looking at this panel, she noticed that this man had spots over his legs. These spots had previously been thought to be just signs of corrosion on the glass, but under the microscope, Leonie was able to confirm that these were actually spots of paint and that this was a sign of leprous spots.
For the first time, Leonie and her colleague Rachel Koopmans were able to start exploring the possibility that this section of the window might tell a story about a man who visited Becket's tomb with leprosy and was cured of his illness. And there's one very well-known story in the Latin collection of Becket's miracle stories about a man with leprosy called Ralph.
So this is the first panel in Ralph's story, and it shows Ralph sitting next to St. Thomas's tomb in the crypt of Canterbury Cathedral as his legs, which are covered in leprous spots and sores, are washed in St. Thomas's water, this concoction of Becket's watered down blood. And he's also offered a bowl of this water to drink by this person by the tomb as well. And the story goes that Ralph was healed of his leprosy after being washed in St. Thomas's water. And he leaves Canterbury on horseback, praising Becket for his healing. And this is what this panel, the now reordered panel, shows. Ralph is shown on horseback, leaving this wonderfully coloured city of Canterbury behind, with his hands raised, thanking Becket. And then a year later, Ralph returns to Canterbury and returns to Becket's tomb to say thanks again for his healing. And in the final panel in this story, he's shown bending over in front of the tomb in gratitude for the work Becket has done. As part of the preparations for the exhibition, Leonie and her team had also done an incredibly detailed measurement of every panel in the window.
At some point in the history of the window's restoration, the panel showing Ralph leaving the city on horseback had become mixed up with another story in the window, a story about a man called Arlwood of Westerning.
And so by switching these two scenes, the narratives of both of these stories can be restored. This is a really exciting discovery because for the first time in 350 years, the stories of Aylward of Westerning and Ralph, who's suffering with leprosy, can be told in full. And visitors to the exhibition will be able to experience these narratives as they were intended to be told in the Middle Ages.